Antonio.
Hi, good afternoon.
Have you any fresh injury concerns ahead of this game against Chelsea, or any players returning?
About injuries and a little problem with Clement, with Lenglet. I don't think he's available for the game against Chelsea, and for sure next game against Wolverhampton, he had a little problem. And then Skip, I think he needs a couple of weeks before to stay again available. And yeah, the others, all the players are good.
Can I just clarify what's the problem with
Clement? No, and he's a little problem of fatigue. He's a bit tired and he's abductor, in the muscle. Nothing of serious, but only percussion. I think that it's not good to take a stupid risk for one game. Yeah, but he's having training session and apart, but I think it's good for him to recover well and to have a good training session before to come back with us.
Last season you talked about the big gap between Tottenham and Chelsea. Do you think the way the transfer windows have gone so far for both clubs, that gap has closed a little bit ahead of this game?
I don't know. I'm not a journalist, and I think you can tell this much better than me. And if I have to reduce the gap, I need to work with the team. And last season we played three games after only two months since I arrived. Now we have 7 months plus one month of pre-season. I think the work, we implemented the work. I think that as a team we are better than last season. Then the transfer market is for us, the transfer market is for Chelsea. But the most important thing is not only to sign players. It's important because especially when you have to face four competitions, you have to need to have a good squad under numerical aspect, also to try to improve the quality. I think we did this, but I think that Chelsea is one of the best team in England and Europe. 2 years ago they won the Champions League, and the last season they won the World Cup as a club. And I think I was there, I know which club we are talking, the investment that they go to do every season.
Do you, as a manager, still need some more signings? And also, what chance do Ndombele, Lo Celso, Reguilon and Winks have of forcing their way into your thinking for the season?
But first of all, we are talking about really good players, and for sure, and about Lo Celso and about Ndombele last season in January, they went alone. No? Ndombele on Lyon and Lo Celso on Villarreal. And then every season there are different targets, and for sure in this season there is the World Cup. There is the World Cup, and many players ask you to play regularly, to give you more opportunity, to give more time to play game. And for this reason, someone can also push, no, to go away and to try to play more in a way more regular. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Hi, Antonio.
Hi.
Other than the new signings, in what ways do you feel your team is better than last season? You just said that a few minutes ago.
Yeah, but I always answer this question. I say that compared last season, we improved. We improved our squad, and but we needed to do this because last season we finished our season with only 13 players. But it was a really normal to do this. Otherwise. We were foolish. Don't do this.
and to face for competitions. And but for me it's strange that for you it's strange this.
No, more so the tactical side of things. What other improvements have you seen?
Yeah, but you have seen the first game we played with the same players of the last season. But for sure, we are better than last season because, I repeat, and we have a squad with a number of players more reliable than the last season. I think we improved the quality because you know that when you go to play every 3 days, you need to make rotations. But if you don't drop the quality of your rotation, I think that you have more probability to have success. And I think Tottenham needed to do this, but it was normal. And only if we were foolish, we didn't do this. I think also the club understood this. And yeah, don't forget that in November we were in trouble. Now I see a lot of optimism. Yeah, but we are talking not a lot of time ago, and in November we were in trouble in many aspects. Now, after we worked 7 months, after we signed some players, I see that there is more optimism, and the environment about the press is good. This, but there is only one way to follow for us, and to try to continue to work in this way. To improve the players, because the level of my players, I think, through the work improved a lot. And for this reason, we need to be optimistic for the improvement of the players, not for other situations.
And then in terms of the game against Chelsea, you just mentioned that you feel they're one of the best teams in the world.
Yeah.
Thomas Tuchel said they're going through a rebuilding stage. There have been exits and new arrivals. What kind of game are you expecting this time around?
I don't want to comment on the words of the other coach, but I can tell you that 2 years ago they won the Champions League. Last season they won the World Cup for club, and we are talking about to rebuild the team. Yeah.
Nigel?
How do you think the heat will affect the game on Sunday?
The weather?
Yeah.
But the weather is the same for him, for them, for us. Yeah. I don't know if in the first half the weather is... the temperature is less for them, higher for us, and the difference. Yeah, it's like the pitch. The pitch is always the same. The weather is always the same for us and for them. And yeah.
You don't think it will affect the tempo?
No, and the weather is this, and we are having training session with this temperature, and for sure I understand that this is unusual, no, for London, for me, no, because in Italy in this period we have 40, 42 degrees, especially in where I was born, in Lecce, yeah, and we touch sometimes 45, yeah. And we are used to this weather, this temperature. But I understand that for London is an unusual this, but the game will be good because both teams want to play, want to try to win. Yeah.
Ali?
You speak about the numerical aspect. In the past you said you want 2 players for every position. Are you there yet? Do you have 2 players for every position in your squad now?
But I think not only for me, but for a club that has to face for competitions is the minimum. and to have 20 players, two players for every role is, I repeat, is the minimum. And maybe especially in this season, because this season is going to be different for the World Cup, and you don't know after the World Cup, the injuries, and maybe the clubs needed more players than 20, only 20 players. But I'm happy also in this way with the 20 players.
The reason I asked is because I was thinking up front, in the three up front, obviously you've got Richarlison, Lucas, who, you know, as well as Kulusevski, Kane and Son. Do you have that other person, the six up front? I mean, you've got Brian Hill, but I don't know what his future holds.
Yeah, but we have in our squad, and I'm very happy because I repeat, compared to last season, we improved our squad with Ricci in front up, but don't forget we lost Bergwijn, and then Gil last season went on loan, and now he's in the squad for in these 20 players. I think as midfielder we improved with Bissouma and with Winks also, and then with Langley, no? Behind. I think that we send players with common sense to find players with the right characteristic to help us to improve the quality and to have players reliable, and players ready to have a good impact and not an impact so and so if I have to call them to play. Yeah.
Charlie?
Do you feel then, Antonio, the squad that you have now is strong enough, good enough to compete on the forefront that you talk about?
We are talking about a good squad, and I always say to you that I think we have just started our process to try to build a strong squad, and this is normal because after only 8 months, I think that we did a really good job with the club together. To improve the players that I started to play with them in January to bring two players like Deki and Rodrigo, and now in the last transfer market to bring other players to improve ourselves, and we have to continue in this way. But I know very well that I can't have everything quickly because it would be foolish to ask a lot of players and to spend a lot amount of money. I think that we are doing the right things with the common sense, not to spend money for amount of money for many players, also because this is not the politic of the club. I understand this. I think that we have to go, you know, in the right way, doing the right things. And I think that we are doing this.
Can I ask as well, are you surprised by, 7 months ago when you Spurs lost to Chelsea those three times in January, and you talked about there being a big gap, and now, 7 months on, you've added 8 players, you finished fourth, you picked up the same number of points per game than Chelsea in that time, you scored more than them per game, conceded fewer per game. Are you surprised by how quickly that turnaround has happened?
For sure, this is a really good surprise because to see the change, no? The change of the team in a so short time is positive. It's positive for me. I can be surprised for the short time, no, that we needed, we had to do this. But now there is the more difficult part, because to have a good improvement quickly can happen. But then when you stay on one level, and to have another step and another step become more difficult because you have to continue to work and you have to continue and don't make mistakes about the players, to sign the players, and this is really, really important because now this is not the moment for Tottenham to make mistakes on the transfer market. No. Yeah.
Roman, do you want to finish this section, please?
Yeah, Antonio, I was born in 1992, and since then, Spurs have only won one league game at Stamford Bridge. How did you change that on Sunday?
1992, huh?
Oh,
yeah, well, yeah. We are talking about 13 years ago. The truth is this, and the story is this. We want to try, and when I arrived in Tottenham, I say that. We want to try to write a good story for this club. I know very well that it will be more difficult than the other club for many reasons. But I think we have started to go in the right path. And for sure on Sunday it will be a difficult game. But we want to play this game. We want to play this game. I want to play this game, my players want to play this game because it would be important this type of game to make a right evaluation, no? About our improvement. And I think this game will be very important for us then. If we win, if we lose or draw, and then we have to be good to make the right evaluation about the game, because also you can win a game and to be lucky, or to lose a game and to be unlucky. For me, it would be very important to understand, to make the right evaluation after the game, the performance, the way that we played, to feel our improvement and for the future, yeah.
You scored 4 goals against Southampton without Son and Kane. Is it a sign that you're building a team that is less reliant on them scoring?
You know very well that for us, Harry and Sonny are vital, because don't forget last season Sonny scored 23 goals and he was the top scorer in the league, and Harry scored 17 goals, and for us we are talking about 2 important players, and we need that they score. But at the same time, and we have to find a different solution. I think the way that we play, the way that we attack, give us different solutions. But a team with ambition and needs to have many solutions to score goal. Yes. At the same time, don't forget, you have to show solidity defensively, because if you want to reach good achievement, it'd be very important always to have a good balance defensively, offensively. Yeah.
Okay. We'll move on to the embargoed section for 10:30 PM tonight, Darren.
Will your experience at Chelsea make it easier for Sunday?